Massive welcome back, guys. So today I am inflatable, can't even talk properly. Inflatable. Here we are.
When you say you can't talk properly, that's the norm.
Inflatable boat fishing. That is what we are doing today. And I'm out with the legendary Rhys, Fish Hunter UK. Guys, if you haven't subbed to him yet, give him a sub. Brilliant page. We're also going to be out with Carlos today as well. So Carlos is all set up, ready to roll as well. We are set up, ready to roll. And yeah, so today I'll be bringing you back on and off, hopefully with some fish in this video, because we haven't had much luck in our recent attempts. So, but yeah, no, really looking forward to this one. It's going to be a new experience for me. And Rhys is quite excited because he's just had a new aluminium floor fitted, which is going to give it a lot more stability on the water and also stability for us guys inside it as well, which is more important. And with the likes of me dropping hooks and things, it's probably not a bad idea actually. So yeah, happy days. Right, okay, well I'll get back to you in a little while, guys. So welcome back to inflatable boat fishing with Rhys, Fish Hunter UK.
Ah, oh, it's brilliant. The thing is, guys, what I've got is I've got a human shield in Luke, so I'm standing nice and dry. Luke, on the other hand, is soaking. I'm trying to stay like Carlo and stay in these little pits.
It is a little bit bumpy, but it's bloody fun. I'm not sure how the stabilisation of this camera is holding up.
Big one!
Whee! Right. So a million miles back there is Littlehampton, where we launched off. And we've come out, how far do you reckon? What, 3 miles?
It's 2.5 apparently to
here. So about 2.5, 3 miles out. And we're heading towards this weather station pole type thing. And we're going to start with some feathers, see if we can get some mackie, see if we can get some bait in for some bigger species, have a scratch about, see what we can find. It is only 8:30 in the morning, and it's not too bad now we've stopped, and Rhys has calmed himself down.
Alright, fun there.
Whoa. And yeah, the wind that is here is going to be dropping off even more so. So it should be quite pleasant.
The way we drifted.
Oh, but yeah, absolutely, what an experience. Beautiful day. Right.
Crash.
Ta-da, everyone. Absolutely beautiful out here. So that weather station, pole type thing, not sure what it was. We've been drifting around there back and forth for about the last 30 minutes. And we've done all right. We've got a good few mackerels. Mackerels? Mackeries? In the pot, ready to go. Now we're going to head off to a rock mark or some rougher ground, which is another
2.5 miles that way.
Another 2.5 miles that direction. So about as far as we've come, again, as such, out this way. The benefit with having rough ground and rocky marks underneath you is it should be abundant of fish species. So hopefully we'll be able to get a few good, decent fish on camera, and lots of different species would be ideal. So yeah, we're going to make our way up there now. The mackie baits are in, right later for the tope. And yeah, we'll see how we get on.
And hopefully Angela's for you.
An underlet, yeah, I'd like an underlet. I'd like a tope, I'd like a bream, I'd like a gurnard, I'd like a bass, I'd like a conger. Yeah, all of them.
Like a 25-year-old blonde.
Yeah, not a spotted blonde though. Right, okay, Captain. Starboard board or whatever you call it. Well, I don't even know what way the shore is now, because we've gone so far out, I don't know where we are. but it's nice and flat calm. We're now fishing over this rock mark, which goes on for quite a distance. So we're over the rough ground. I've just had some hawkeyes out, but I feel like they're a bit too big. So basically, Gavin, as always, has come up trumps for me. And he has literally given me a great big bag full of all sorts of bits and pieces.
Oh, fish on, Luke, live.
Now
live.
I've got Muppets. Oh, you got one on?
Yeah.
What do you think you got?
All right, I've got a mackerel.
A mackerel?
Oh.
Steady on there, my
easy,
friend.
Easy, old boy.
Is it a mackie?
Yeah, I'm pretty certain.
Yeah, look at
one,
it.
Isn't it?
Couple of mackies.
There's a couple of mackies. I'm going to loosen the drag off them for effect.
Yeah, so we've got plenty of mackies coming out. So we've got plenty of bait for the tow. Look at the mess it's made.
Well, that's the last of those feathers.
So anyway, what was I saying? So now, I don't know if you guys know, but Gav also does loads of boat rigs and stuff. So he's given me some Muppets and stuff here for wrecking.
You sound about me?
Yep, you fought it, not me. So I've got my tope rigs ready for later on. I've got all sorts of, I'm not really clued up with boat stuff, but there's all boom stuff here and running ledger things with booms on. And Gavin's probably going to be killing me because I don't know what I'm talking about, just other than the fact that I've got all this stuff with tubes on. And yeah, so basically what I'm getting at is Gavin also does loads and loads of stuff for boats, not just the shore. Another Mackie in the bag.
Sorry, mate.
That's my lunchbox. Get out! Stay there!
That one pooed on me.
Right, so now what I've done is I want some little bream as such. So this is Gavin's little pop-up rig. I don't know if you can see it. So there's a little floating bead there. I've got a little scrap of squid. It goes up to a little bit of tubing that just kicks it out as such, like a little boom. So that kicks that out. There's two of them there. And we'll see how that gets on. Hopefully I'll have a little, few little bream or something. Oh, mate, these mackies are doing my head in. Stop! Okay, right. Let's see if I can get a bream on camera. Ta-da. Guys, you won't believe what has just happened. So we've moved down to some smoother ground with some gullies and bits and pieces. We've both got a tope rod out each, and Rhys has still got some feathers just in case he can get a mackerel. Well, guess what? On the feathers, and I'm not even joking you, look, there is a feather in its mouth. Would you believe it? A bloody tope on feathers.
What a fight.
Well done, matey.
What a fight.
Well done.
Right, I'm going to try and get this to hook out of its mouth the best I can. So if I lay it down there and get my pliers.
Right. Well, see you later, guys, but what a fish. On feathers. Right, so we've moved mark again. Rhys has just had a hound and now a lovely bass. And that is coming home with me for tea. Thank you very much, my friend.
No worries at all, mate. Look down there, hang on. You wouldn't want to be a little fish down there, would you?
Gobble, gobble, gobble.
We all like a little gobble, gobble, gobble.
Oh, no, I don't know. I'm all right. You might like having a little gobble, gobble, but... Yeah.
Cracking fish.
Well done, dude, well done. It's a cracking day out here. Absolutely loving the whole experience of being on one of these sibs. And I don't know if I've mentioned, but for anyone who's watching and quite likes the idea of this sib, you should look up inflatableboatfishing.com, and the chap that sells them is called Carlo. And yeah, go and have a look at it. It's I can't tell you, they are a fantastic bit of kit. Really, really impressed with it. So anyhow, there we go, and we will talk soon. Ta-da. Well, that was us, guys. So we're back home now. Bloody awesome trip today. Really enjoyed that. And Mr. Bass has come home with me. And he will make a nice dinner. So he's all been cleaned out. Yes, very, very nice. Right, guys, until the next one. Toodle pip.